Bonjour. Today we are going to learn some punctuation marks that are given on page number 12 of your book. So first of all, open page number 12, page numero 12. La ponctuation. La ponctuation. Punctuations are known as la ponctuation. So first of all, we are going to learn about this, the apostrophe sign. La apostrophe. You must have seen it in say. So when we write say, we use an apostrophe sign. So this is known as l'apostrophe. Then the dash or the hyphen is known as le trait d'union. Le trait d'union. Then the full stop. Full stop means le point. Full stop is le point. Then the exclamation mark. It is le point d'exclamation. Then question mark. Le point d'interrogation. Le point d'interrogation, which means interrogation mark. Then the comma. Comma is la virgule. La virgule. Now, we are going to learn about the quotation marks. Quotation marks are known as les guillemets. Guillemets. Les guillemets. Then the at the rate sign. It is known as arrobas. La, l'arrobas. So at the rate sign is l'arrobas. Then the underline is known as le sous-tiré. Le sous-tiré. Then the space is known as l'espace. L'espace. Then capital letters are known as la majuscule. La majuscule. Then small letters are known as le minuscule. Le minuscule. So, apostrophe is l'apostrophe, hyphen is trait d'union, full stop is le point, exclamation mark is le point d'exclamation, interrogation mark or question mark is le point d'interrogation, comma is la virgule, quotation marks are les guillemets, at the rate sign is l'arrobas. Underline is sous-tiré, space is l'espace, capital letters are la majuscule and small letters are la minuscule. Now we are going to learn about pronunciations in French and how to pronounce different words in French. As it is given on page number 13, a guide to pronunciation. So the first one is, in French the letter H is mostly silent. As a letter it has a sound, but in words it is usually not pronounced. So H is usually treated as silent when we pronounce it in a word. In French we call it H. For example, homme, man, hotel, hotel, horloge, wall clock. Second, the letter J sounds like measure in S in measure. So J or J has a sound of J. So J means I, jardin means garden. Third is, letters T and D have a soft pronunciation. Unlike in English, where we pronounce them as T and D. So, te and they. For example, tube, that is you, tomat, tomato, table, table, disc, disc, dealing, dinner, DPC, difficult. Letter C is followed by letters I and E sounds like S, but elsewhere sounds like K. So, if we put letter C or sir with I and E, they sound like C and sir. But if we pair them with A, O, U, they sound like ka, ko, q. Now, in French, ch always has the sound of sh. So whenever you look at ch, you always pronounce that sh. For example, chaise, chateau, chante, and chapeau. Sixth is, some letters in a word are not pronounced in French. The last consonant in a word is not pronounced. We have learned this in class 6 also, that last consonant of a word is 99% of the time not pronounced. We don't pronounce it and it is treated as silent. For example, sha, peti, raison and taba. The last e in a word is also not pronounced. For example, théâtre, theatre, difficile and aim. Now on the next page there is a note that says, when there is an e after the last consonant in a word, the consonant is pronounced. For example, etudiant becomes etudiante, petty becomes petty.